There are plenty of people who only hear what they want to hear, and they only watch the sort of, you know, ideas they want to watch, right? So those people today might have seen Stephen Miller, right? Trump's top aide. And he's saying, forget December 14th, right? Forget January 6th even, and that whole thing about the floor of Congress. He's now saying January 20th, trying to buy every single bit of air that they can for Trump supporters. Here's what Stephen Miller said.
The only date in the Constitution is January 20th. So we have more than enough time to right the wrong of this fraudulent election result and certify Donald Trump as the winner of the election. As we speak today, an alternate slate of electors in the contested states is going to vote, and we're going to send those results up to Congress.
I mean, this is completely made up. I mean, they may be doing it, right? But it's a completely made up thing.
Totally
and yet,
made
you know,
up.
they're getting broadcast to millions of people who are hearing this sort of thing. So
and
put it to rest.
Aaron, many of them are armed and dangerous. What these people are doing, Stephen Miller, prime among them, is stirring up violence. They're the kind of violence that required special protection for the electors in the state of Michigan. They are inciting violence. They're engaged in essentially sabotage. Yes, January 20th is the date in the Constitution, but well beyond the 20th, these people are going to be out there, whether it's in Mar-a-Lago or somewhere else, encouraging the sort of armed rebellion to kill people. And I think that's a scary thing, not just for democracy, but for the people who want to go on with their lives. We've got a terrible pandemic. We have an economy in shambles as a result of this president's failure to deal with the pandemic. We have a new president, a new sheriff in town, who this evening is going to tell us something more of his plans. And in the meantime, these sore losers are out there trying to stir up violence. It's really a sad day for America, and yet a happy day, because democracy has prevailed.